So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, ahmaduhu wa salli ala rasulil kareem, amma ba'd, fa'audhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim, qad bada'at al-baghda min afwahihim wa ma tukhfa wa ma tukhfi suduruhum akbar, rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri, wa ahlul uqadata min lisani yafkahu qawli, Allahumma alhimni rushdi wa aizni min sharri nafsi. اللهم الهمنا رشدنا وعزنا من شرور انفسنا اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه امين يا رب. I want to share something very important with you. We'll go over it inshallah quickly. And we all know that Ben Shapiro has been talking a lot in defense of Israel, as you all may know. And I will later talk about Ben Shapiro and his relationship with Israeli intelligence at another time. But I want to, and may Allah bless Brother Muhammad Hijab and this other brother who I guess is known as Loki in one of their recent podcasts. It was a superb podcast, the things that they revealed. May Allah bless them a billion, billion times. But I want to actually focus on something that was said, and actually I'm going to make other videos focusing on different aspects, because what he said needs to be exfoliated and expanded and looked into and looked at with a microscope. And what I'm going to show you is, you can say, a translation or an explanation rather of a verse of the Quran that we should all be aware of. And what is happening in the world today, I don't have time to get into it, but there is a very big, a very deep, a very dangerous agenda behind everything that is going on. Everything that is happening is taking us to a certain point in history with a very dangerous agenda. Now, Ben Shapiro wrote an article in 2003, called Transfer is Not a Bad Word. What this article shows is what is inside the heart of this very dangerous person. And it shows what is in the heart of this very dangerous person. And what is in the heart of this dangerous person is, you can say, the Quran sheds light on that. So what does Ben Shapiro do? In 2003, he writes an article. And the name of the article is, Transfer is Not a Bad Word. Transfer is not a bad word. See, Zionism is not completed as a project as long as the Jews don't control all of Israel. There's no Zionism without Jerusalem. And so you have to remove the Arabs from Israel. And so he writes an article called Transfer is Not a Bad Word. Ben Shapiro is an Orthodox Jew, the types that want the Messiah to come. He is the type of Jew who believe Masjid al-Aqsa should be dropped and the temple should be built in its place. He's the type of the Jew that believes that the non-Jews need to follow the Noahide laws, and the Jews are superior and they will follow the Torah, and the Noahide laws will be enforced on the entire world. And that the Messiah, this is his words, that the Messiah will enforce the Noahide laws on the world. His words, that the Messiah will be a political figure. His words, the Messiah, Ben Shapiro, could be any Jew, including me maybe, he said. So, let us see what he wrote in 2003. Okay. Let me see if I can get that. Yes, this is the article. Transfer is not a dirty word. 2003, August 27th. Let me just read parts of this article. In the beginning, he says, you know, raise your hand if you're shocked at the breakdown of the so-called Middle East Road, because don't you know that the two people will never get along, and especially the Arabs are so bad that the roadmap was doomed to start from the Arab enmity for the Jews. And the state of Israel allows for no peace process. The time for half measures has passed. Bulldozing houses of homicide bombers is useless. Instituting ongoing curfews in Arab-populated cities is useless. Roadblocks, touch fences, midnight negotiations, ceasefires are all useless. Some have rightly suggested that Israel will be allowed to decapitate the terrorist leadership of the Palestinian Authority. But this, too, is only a half measure. The ideology of the Palestinian population is indistinguishable from the terrorist leadership. And this is the point that one of the big points that they're trying to make with this war. We can't tell who's Palestinian, who is the terrorist, who is the Islamic resistance, who is the terrorist. I don't know what you want to call it. Okay? Whatever you call it, you can't distinguish it from the rest of the population. This is the point that they're trying to make. So what's the solution? The thing that they're trying to push Sisi about. And remember, according to the sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Israel will invade over Egypt. Okay? So, what is his very humane solution to this? Half measures merely postpone our realization the Arab's dream of Israel's deconstruction. Without drastic measures, the Arab dream will never come true. So, oh, now he's being nice. So you see, like, the Arab dream of having your, versus what? The Arabs, they hate Israel and Jews. Okay, so this contrast. So now, all of a sudden, the Arab dream will never come true in the short term. The establishment of Palestinian state based in Judea, Samaria, and Gaza cuts Israel to the bone. Why? Why does it cut Israel to the bone? Why can't the only democracy in the Middle East have people of different races living together? Why does it cut you to the bone? Because Samaria and Gaza and Judea are holy to them. To the Zionists, their God is the land called Israel. That is holy to them. Even though all their history, they were never one. There was Judea in the north, and there was Israel in the south. Just to begin with, as soon as Daoud alayhi salatu wasalam, then Suleiman alayhi salatu wasalam, after Suleiman alayhi salatu wasalam, divided into two. They were never one. Anyway, in some places, Israel would be an unthinkable 9 miles wide. And some places, as if Israel is a god, a holy cow. Israel will only be only 9 miles wide in some places. How could we do this to the holy cow of ours? In the long term, the growth of the hostile Israeli Arab population within the pre-1967 Israeli bodies ill for the future of the Jewish state. As University Haifa professor Aron Sofer says, the trends and indicators all point to an economic and ecological catastrophe waiting to happen and the death of Nell at the ideological dream of a Jewish state. So basically, the ideological dream of a Jewish state, which means that Arabs have no control of any part of what is called Israel. This is now Ben Shapiro, the one who acts all fancy intellectual. Look, let me tell you one of the downfalls of being an ideologue. One of the problems of being an ideologue is that you get trapped in your way of thinking. You get trapped in your way of thinking. If the ideology that you believe in is false, and the solutions that you believe in based upon those ideologies, if they're false, then you're stuck in that way of thinking. And then you become an apologist. You just try to defend your position, right? And so this is what's Ben Shapiro is basically a Zionist apologist. He's a Zionist defender for what cannot be defended. He is limited to his puny little idea of this land being the sacred cow. Okay, And you know, he may be whatever he is, but he's certainly not able to get beyond the idea and the understanding that he's trapped in an ideological falsehood. It's an ugly solution, but it is the only. Okay, so he says the Jewish state has the right to exist. What does it have to do with Palestinians? Then you must allow Israel to transfer Palestinians and Arab Israeli Arabs, meaning Arabs who are living in Israel, not in Gaza, not in the West Bank. These are the Arabs who've compromised as much as one can compromise, and they're living amongst the Israelis as equal citizens, to which they are not. Must allow Israel to transfer Palestinians and the Israeli Arabs from Judea, Samaria, Gaza, and Israel proper. It's an ugly solution, but it is the only solution, and it is far less ugly than the prospect of a bloody conflict ad infinitum, meaning forever. When two populations are constantly enmeshed in conflict, it is insane to suggest that somehow deep-seated ideological change will miraculously occur, allowing two sides to live together. Unfortunately, this insanity is generally accepted as the only way forward. President Bush accepts it because it is politically palatable. The Arabs accept it. For them, it is a Trojan horse. I won't go into what he's trying to say. He's trying to say that, you know, Arabs are going to accept this only to betray the ideology of the Jews at the end. Israelis accept it because they're afraid that if they expel the Arabs, they will be called the Nazis. For anyone who lived through the Holocaust or who has relatives who died in it, being called a Nazi is unspeakably terrible. This is the secret weapon of the Arabs. Anytime the Jews get wise and threaten mass expulsion of the Arabs pull out their big stick, equating Nazism with Zionism. Oh, really? Their cartoons merge swastikas with Stars of David. Their newspapers called Ariel Sharon another Adolf Hitler. Their spokespeople cries genocide. Jews cower in fear that they could be equated with their parents' murderers. Jews don't realize that expelling a hostile population is a commonly used and generally effective way of preventing violent entanglements. There's no gas chambers here. It's not genocide. It's not transfer. It's not Hitler. It's Churchill. Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Churchill, and Mr. Hitler, and Mr. Ben Shapiro. Prophet Muhammad said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the one, man qatala duna malihi fahuwa shaheed. The one who dies defending his wealth, his property, is a martyr. So when you expel a people, you are telling them that you can now you're giving them a reason to be hostile to you legally from the Quranic perspective. Because Muslims were allowed to fight back when they were expelled from their houses in Mecca. And the Quran mentions this. So when you expel a people, you have declared war on them. That is the very definition of war. Is that when you try to remove people, when you go to war, you're going over war on a certain land to take over people, to fight them, to expel them, to exterminate them. That is, you're just using a different word that just already means war. And just because it's been done in other times in history doesn't just justify it. Doesn't mean it's moral. Okay? After World War II, Poland was recreated by the Allied powers. In doing so, Allies sliced off a chunk of Germany and extended Poland west to of such and such line. Anywhere from 3.5 million to 9 million Germans were forcibly expelled from the new Polish territory and relocated in Germany. British Prime Minister Winston Churchill was pleased with the result. The Prophet Muhammad wouldn't be pleased with the result. In 1944, he had explained to the House of Commons that expulsion is the method which, so far as we have been able to... Okay, there's one exception. And that is that you can remove people from a certain area if they're causing trouble in that area. But in this case, the occupier is Israel. So if we have to judge who should be removed, it is the one who is causing the fitna. It is the one who is expelling the people from their houses. It is the one that is doing يَقْتُلُونَ أَبْنَاءَكُمْ وَيَسْتَحْيُونَ نِسَاءَكُمْ, killing your baby children. The one who should be expelled is the one who is causing the problems. And the Quran mentions this about such people. Anyway, expulsion is a method which, so far as we've been able to see, will be the most satisfactory and lasting. There will be no mixture of populations to cause endless trouble. A clean sweep will be made. I'm not alarmed by the prospect of disentanglement of populations, nor even by these large transferences, which are more possible in modern conditions than they were ever before. Churchill was right. The Germans accepted the new border. Decades of conflict between Poles and Germans ended. Arab-Jewish conflict is exponentially more volatile than German and Polish conflict ever was, which is a reason why this will not work, ever. The solution, because you're transferring one place, Europe as small as it is, you're transferring from Poland to German or German to Poland, it's the same general location. But this is not the case here. You want to kick them out of Israel to a different continent. The Arab-Jewish conflict is exponentially more volatile than German-Polish conflict ever was. The solution is far easier. If there was a room in Germany for German populations of East of Prussia and of other territories, as Churchill stated, there is certainly room for spacious Muslim states of the Middle East for 5 million Palestinians and Israeli Arabs. So there should be no Israeli Arabs there even. If Germans who had a centuries-old connection to the newly created Polish territory could be expelled, then surely Palestinians who claim to Judea, Samaria, and Gaza is dubious at best can be expelled. Of course, he had to say dubious at best. It's time to stop being squeamish. Jews are not Nazis. Transfer is not genocide. Anything else is not a solution. No, there is other solutions. It's called start acting like a human being. It's called, you don't have a right to that territory. Go back to the lands you came from. I'm not saying this. Your own Jewish rabbis say this. That God sent you across and gave you a diaspora so you can be a light to the world. You cannot be a light to the world if you're in the state of Israel. And so, unless you're thinking you're going to dominate the world and control the world, which you are. So, this is Ben Shapiro. Brothers and sisters, and again, before I show you the verse of Quran, I want to thank Allah, first of all, that He allowed me to hear that conversation of Brother Muhammad Hijab, may Allah bless him, and that brother who calls himself Low Key, and may Allah bless them both, and open doors for them, and use them for the work of the deen. Okay, now I want to share with you a particular verse of the Quran, and then I might want to share with you a video clip or so. We're going to see how that turns out, inshallah. Okay, so now that this war is happening, and the population of Gaza is being moved, why would Ben Shapiro not be on the side of that, being a Zionist Jew who wants to bring in the Messiah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you people who claim to believe, La tattakhidhu bitanatan min dunikum, don't take as friends who you share secrets with other than yourselves, who la ya'lunakum khibala, who don't ever seize for your destruction. Waddu ma'anittum, and they want what distresses you, what hurts you, they want that. قَدْ بَدَأَتِ الْبَغْضَاءُ مِنْ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ, already has come out from their mouths hatred and enmity. Didn't you read this article? 2003. Didn't you see this article? This is before this war. So, وَمَا, and this is the part I want to share with you, وَمَا تُخْفِي صُدُورُهُمْ أَكْبَرُ, and what is in their hearts is greater than that. The hate they have for you is greater than that. O Muslims, understand that. they are the ones who hate you, and then they project their own hatred that they have for you, that you have for them. قَدْ بَيَّنَّا لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ Allah says, look, we made everything clear for you. إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ So you will have understanding, so you will have restraint, so you will have a realization of the truth, of the situation. هَأَنْتُمْ هَأُولَيْ تُحِبُّونَهُمْ You can show love to them. وَلَا يُحِبُّونَكُمْ But they will not love you. And that is the fact. Now let me share with you one more thing.
Rabbi's book says Jews can kill Gentiles, along with their Zionist agenda, a threat.
I wanted to mention this rabbi that is being mentioned here is one of the heroes of Ben Shapiro. Okay, so now with that, listen to what he has to say.
I saw a really funny impressionist of Ben Shapiro. I wonder if I can find that. The guy was on point. Rabbi's book says Jews can kill Gentiles. Jews can kill non-Jews who threaten Israel. They consider anybody that doesn't go along with their Zionist agenda a threat. So they can kill you, is their mindset that they have. You don't believe that they're chosen by God, they can kill you. That's literally how they interpret this. The 1906 Jewish Encyclopedia states that with few exceptions, the breaking of the Jewish Noahide laws is punishable by death by decapitation. We also learned that Noahide law set up a two-tier legal system, one for Jews and one for non-Jews. That sounds fair, right?
I respect you,
respect you.
That is the right thing. Are you Jewish? Do you want to honor God? That is the godly thing to do. We respect one another.
The godly thing is to kill me.
That's right. That's what the Torah says.
The Torah says to kill us.
The Torah says that people who worship idols such as yourself, when there is a Sanhedrin,
to kill us.
Yes.
Okay.
That's what the Torah says.
So we know how the Jewish people feel about Christians, yes? That you discriminate against Christians.
Now, notice over here how Ben Shapiro thinks about Jews and the world. Okay, so now notice this is what's coming out of their tongue. Not just about Muslims, but about the world. And imagine Muslims on top of that.
People are going to think of you as Jewish, whether you want them to or not. There's just no way to escape that. People are going to they will label anything bad that you do as Jewish and anything good that you do as non-Jewish.
I love how he flips it there, because whenever a Jew does something good, they're Jewish. And Jewish genius, they win a Nobel Prize, they're Jewish. When they do something bad, Epstein, Weinstein, they all of a sudden become white, and white people are bad.
Unless you are overt about the fact that what you are doing in your daily life is Jewish, and you're modeling a particular set of behaviors that are providing a kiddush Hashem that extends beyond your home. Right?
So, Ben Shapiro, his reality, it's completely useless to talk to this person unless you have him on record say that these are his ideas from the beginning. You know, because I have a lot of Muslims who came to me and said, oh, no one can argue with Ben Shapiro, he has such good arguments. Well, the first place to begin with any person, whether it is Ben Shapiro or Freud or anybody that you're trying to investigate, the first thing you should do is start with what is their heart. And over here, we see what is the heart. The heart from which we have these words. Ben Shapiro. May Allah forgive us and guide us, and may Allah protect us from the plans of the shayateen. Ameen. Allahumma ameen ya Rabb. Difficult days are ahead for Muslims. Very, very difficult days. Very unimaginably difficult days. What they're doing in Gaza will not be limited to Gaza. It'll be coming to your cities. It's just a matter of time.